That was so shocking. But definitely not have an occasion of throwing money in the air. Minasan konnichiwa, and welcome to Let's Ask Shogo. I'm Shogo, and this is my wife, Harumi. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
And today is actually our wedding anniversary. Yatta! So Harumi is gonna have some pop water, and I'm gonna have this Japanese sparkling sake, Mio.
Mio.
I was actually pretty excited to drink this.
Omedetou! Omedetou! Arigatou! Yay!
Because Harumi is Chinese and I am Japanese, we were lucky enough to have two weddings in both countries 3 years ago. Thankfully, we have some videos left about how each video looked like. So we're going to be playing the videos for you, so you can take a look at how different the weddings are like in China and Japan. A lot of people think that China and Japan are basically the same, but for us, there are a lot of interesting differences. After playing the videos, Harumi and I will be counting down the five most surprising things that we found out about the difference of the two weddings. それでは本日も参りましょう。 Then, number five we'll start from. Where our relatives were at the party. So, it's interesting how in Japan, like your parents, your close relatives, sit the farthest away from you. That's because the wedding is not for your relatives, it's for the people who supported you. And relatives, because you're close to them, they need to be humble, I guess, you know, and sit a little bit farther away. Literally the farthest away, actually. But in China, it was a little bit different, right? Yes.
中国はもう一番ステージのすぐ前に家族と親戚と一同がいて、で近い順に友達とかでちょっと遠い、あとは偉いお偉いさんとかもまあ比較的前だけど、もう結局一番前はもう全員親戚みたいな。
Who sits in the farthest back then?
お父さんの友達とか。
OK。
まあでも後ろの方はもうほとんど決めてない。そもそも座席あんまり決めずに、
Just randomly sit anywhere you can. OK.
でも前の方は親戚だよねっていうのはなんかもうみんなあるから座らなくて。
That's interesting too. Because in Japan, every seat is all decided. It all has name cards on it. Each seat, you know. So you have to sit exactly where it's already decided. So that's interesting. Yeah, we decided together who will sit where. And you have to let the people who you work with, your job related people, sitting closest to you. Because they're the people who help you in your life the most. So you have to let them sit the closest to show them respect. So that was a very big difference. Number five. Number four, the values towards money. So let's start from Japan. So in Japan, like the people who are being celebrated, like in this case, Harumi and I, will never see any money during the ceremony. The people will pay money like for celebrations, you know, happy wedding, and they'll give you money. But the receptionists are people, usually your friends will do it for you. The two who are getting married are getting prepared and won't see the money until the wedding is over completely. That's very interesting. While in China though, the red envelopes, you know, I was throwing into the room, those have money in it. You kind of throw that for a celebration, right? It's kind of giving money to everyone? Because they're thankful, or what is it for? So the person who's being celebrated should pay the money.
だから普通にこう誕生日の時にその人がおごられるんじゃなくておごる。
That's really interesting. That's already different than from
そうね。なんか、ま、基本的にみんなお金を出すっていう文化で、人が訪ねてきてくれたりとかしたらもちろん出すしとか、そういうのはね、日本もあるけど、まあ、お金をとにかく出したいっていうことだから結婚式もお祝い事の自分の一番の祝い事だからもういっぱい出す。余ったらすごい。
Yeah, that's right, exactly. I made some videos about why earning money is evil in Japan. And in Japan, there's this culture handing money to someone, especially naked money to someone, is very rude and thought of as a vulgar act. So you are handing money to someone, but you're kind of like doing it while you're hiding it, you know? And it's your feelings and not the money itself. You shouldn't be walking around and throwing money in the air. I guess it's thought of as a vulgar act in Japan. Yeah, it's a difference in culture, I mean. I enjoyed it in China. It was a lot of fun, definitely. You would definitely not have an occasion of throwing money in the air. So it was fun for me. It was really, really fun. Everyone's happy. Yeah, and the red envelopes are really beautiful too. Gorgeous, so. Then, number three. In China especially, the men have to do a lot of things during the ceremony. There's so much trouble they have to go through. Yeah, in the video too, what's the culture about? Of the door and everyone like yelling towards you like that you're inside the room. What was that about?
You do that. いやそのそこに苦労があったり困難がこれからもあるからそれをまあ象徴してるんだと思うんだけど、努力をして嫁を勝ち取ったっていうセレモニーだから、
You have to win your wife.
そうそう、だからもう全員邪魔してくるし、外に出るための靴がまずないし。
Yeah. So they have the doors. They stop you at the door. You have to push the door open. You go inside. You find your wife, but they don't. She's not wearing shoes. So you have to find the shoes. that's hidden somewhere inside the room or house. And then finally, is that it? Or is there anything else? Small games too, yeah. And the video I was doing, I was like doing push-ups, right? That was like one of the games that her friends thought up of. There was a phone on the floor. And on the phone, there was a picture of Harumi. And I needed to do the push-ups and kiss the phone like a few times. Yeah, there was like these small games I had to do, yeah. It was fun though. But in Japan, we don't do this. You were saying, in China, weddings are more like celebrations, like festivals. But in Japan, it's more like a ritual ceremony. You don't do things for fun. You do it as like a period in your life where you tell everyone, I'm an adult now. You have to try to appeal that you're mature and you're grown up now and not like playing games like in China. So the purpose, you know, is completely different. But I did have a lot of fun though. Everyone laughing and enjoying the atmosphere. Number two, some of the participants were wearing jeans. So this was one of the things I was actually surprised the most. You didn't notice it too much, right? You were saying, because you spent a lot of time in China, like 5 years, and you have relatives in China, obviously. So for me, you know, a wedding is where everyone, you know, wears suits and dresses, and, you know, wear their best clothes they have, you know, take part in a wedding. But in China, in our wedding, there were people in their jeans and shirts they would probably wear to go walking outside, you know. It was really... Some people were wearing dresses too. Like in the videos, her close friends were all wearing beautiful dresses. But, you know, relatives like uncles and grandpas, those kind of relatives were like literally in jeans with their shirts tucked into their jeans. It was really shocking for me. Yeah, but that's quite normal, right?
けど、まあね、一番近い人たちは私が準備したドレスだったんだけど、じゃなくて普通の友達でもワンピース着てる人たちもいたけど、とかは結構海外の文化が好きで知ってて。
Okay. So that means in China there are no rules about what clothes you wear?
もうルールがないだと思う。
Oh, that's completely different.
I mean,
like in Japan, if you try to join a wedding in jeans and just a t-shirt, they'll probably not let you in, I think. They would probably tell you to go buy clothes somewhere before you go inside. Again, it's because it's close to a, you know, ritual ceremony. Somewhere that you properly do things. So jeans would definitely not be allowed. Alright, lastly, number five. Taking everything away from the wedding celebration was super, super fast. That was so shocking. In China, when we did the wedding, my relative was just my mother. But she was like so shocked, her jaws were literally on the ground. When the celebration, the wedding ended in China, like all the speeches and all the small games were all over, everyone was still at their seats eating the food. But the staff members started to take away everything from the hall and from the stages. So like in the video, you saw the big screen and the flowers and the red carpet and everything. People, the participants, everyone was still there and eating it. All the staff members were ripping everything off. The flowers like boom down the floor. And we're still literally eating. I mean, it's understandable that if you're taking away the plates that's gone, then the food is gone, right? But if you still have people there, it doesn't mean that it's over, right?
日本では絶対ないね。
That company would probably be gone in like 3 days if they do that.
中国は、あの、いとこの結婚式とか、
yeah, yeah.
もう毎回。で、もうお花もらっていくみたいな。欲しい人が、もうドーンってなって落ちてるから、もらおうみたいな。
And you take the flowers back.
あの、カーペットもね、コロコロコロ。
Yeah, exactly. They started to take away the red carpet as well. The carpet was like rolling. Funny though, I love China, so that was really funny. In Japan, I mean, the staff members would probably still be bowing to you when you're leaving the place, I think. That's right. We let all the guests leave first as we bow and say thank you for coming. Yeah. And so we're the last to leave.
で、その後2人が着替えて、荷物まとめて、お会計して、で、お祝儀の袋からいただいて、じゃあって言って帰るとこにも、もうお辞儀してたもんね。
Exactly, exactly.
そっから片付けだもんね。
That's right. That's when they finally start cleaning everything up. So very different. That was the most shocking part of all.
爆笑だった。
Yeah, exactly. So that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. If you found the differences between Chinese and Japanese weddings interesting, please hit the like button to let us know. And our goal is to achieve 100,000 subscribers by January 2022, so your help would mean a lot. Thanks again, and we'll see you in our next video. どうもありがとうございました。